singing Me, My Bobby McGee with my mom was really fun. My dad's speech too, I thought that was
cool. Well, that was great, yeah.
And her first dance. I liked the whole wedding. All of it. Every moment. Let's just do it again, man. I was a morning person until I met Steve. He wakes up like singing.
Are completely surrounded by people who love you.
I love you guys.
Love you.
And I was blown away by the amount of support that we had. I think that was a part of why I felt so solid, because it was like, wow, all these people showed up to support us and celebrate us.
Today is such a great gathering of friends, families that have known each other for decades. Feel the peace and joy of being surrounded by family and friends who will love you and support you now and throughout your life. How providential that both of you met at a wedding rehearsal.
She had a pink top on, and that's what I remember, the pink top, the dark hair, and the big smile.
God was just doing a run through for you. He didn't know it.
It's at Fish House, like a welcome dinner kind of cocktail party for Shannon in DC. Of course, I initially thought he was attractive because he is. So then he comes in town again for Christmas. So I called him and I said, I'm not sure about dinner, but I'm going to yoga at 6.
Oh, yes, the yoga.
If you want to join. And you were like, let me, I'll call you back.
I didn't know what all that involved at the time. Had to do some YouTube.
Did you really YouTube?
Yeah, of course.
So then, you know, we had been talking and keeping in touch, and you had a bachelor party in New Orleans, and I had a bachelorette party, and we were going to get together.
Jake Winter's bachelor party.
Yeah. I remember telling some of the girls, I said, I think we might get together on Sunday.
Super Bowl Sunday.
Also Super Bowl Sunday.
Yeah.
And so it's like, if people go see Black Swan with me, then they're not serious about me. That night, it was total fireworks. This kiss, and I was like, something is serious about this. I'm not sure what. And that was the first time I thought, like, just kind of knocked my socks off. Who goes to bed earlier? Who gets up earlier? Who said I love you first? I remember how cute it was. We were actually driving to Nashville when he said it. We were at a stoplight. Making out. I said something funny, or he said something funny, he laughed, and he was just like, I love you. And then he took my head and like,
I kind of, that one's kind of surprised me. It kind of just jumped out of my mouth. I knew it early on, then I had to convince her for 6 months that it was okay, and then she finally fell for it. Well, fell for me, I should say. When you were walking down the aisle, I was like, finally the show is on the road.
And I love having my mom and dad there. My dad was really sweet. It was really special. Right before I walked down the aisle, everyone I love in that room, all the women from the Blessing Way, we got in a circle and all put our hands on the back of the heart center. That moment was like experience. It was so powerful. Right before my dad came in and got us, and I remember just feeling like I was so fortunate to be so emotionally and spiritually prepared. Like, I felt like I couldn't wait to give all of myself to Steve.
Of honor speeches and talk about Colleen's past relationship. One of these was a great friend without the romantic spark. And the other was a romantic spark without the friendship. She knew it at the time, even though it took her a while to admit it, that she yearned to have it all. A partner in life who was both a great love and also a best friend.
I already feel right about this.
am with Steve, I feel more myself than I ever have.
It just got so much better, and did you ever think it could be this good?
I think he really sees who I am and really likes it, and that's really cool.
I'm Steve's little brother. I grew up with Steve. I work with Steve. Steve lives next door to me. And I gotta say, I've never seen him like this. I'm really glad he found you, Colleen. You're one of the most compassionate people, caring people I've ever met.
The great thing about tomorrow is you get to marry your best friend.
I choose you, Colleen, to be my wife.
I choose you, Colleen, to be my wife.
I choose you, Stephen.
I choose you, Stephen.
To be my husband. I vow to choose gratitude, laughter, and forgiveness.
To choose gratitude, laughter, and forgiveness.
To choose gratitude, laughter, and forgiveness.
To allow God's light and guidance.
To allow God's light and guidance.
To illuminate our path.
To illuminate our path.
To grow with you and create with you.
To grow with you and create with you.
Loving who you are now.
Loving who you are now.
And who you are yet to become.
And who you are yet to become.
I give you my hand to hold.
I give you my hand to hold.
And my love to keep always.
And my love to keep always.
My thing was just not to stutter when I said my vows.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Just go nice and smooth through them. And I did. I think it was great.
Where does love come from? And how does love stay? The answers to these questions are revealed in the story we just heard proclaimed in today's gospel, where Jesus performed his first public miracle. Where else? At a wedding feast. I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
We are one.
We are one.
Jesus knew that once he performed this miracle publicly, his life and his mother's life would change forever. Jesus looks past all of this. He'd said my hour had not come, but he decided, no, it's here. It's here now. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it for this couple. Just like he's going to say, I'm going to do it for Colleen and Stephen. I'm going to give them the gift of everlasting love.
That group of guys, that group of girls on a boat. When am I ever going to be around, you know, those group of people without any
all
kids?
Yeah.
Everybody was together like one more time, and then that won't happen again. You know,
yeah.
It
won't.
Donovan,
I love y'all. Congratulations. Raise a glass to this beautiful bride and groom. And cheers to you. Into a lifetime of happily ever after. Colleen and Steve.
The Prem Sagar, oceans of love for both of you.
Raise your glasses to Colleen and Steve.
First kiss. We kind of like practiced our first kiss for the whole engagement.
We would go to different weddings and see other people's first kiss. I was like, we can't do that. Well, I know we did too, didn't we? The comeback. You wanted the comeback.
But God has joined together, may no one divide.